So let's talk about cache affinity and modern multi-core processors. In modern multi-core processors, you have multiple cores on a single processor. And in addition to the multiple cores that are on a single processor, the processors themselves are also hardware multi-threaded. What hardware multi-threading means is that if a thread that is currently running on a processor, or a core C1, is experiencing a long latency operation, for instance, it misses in the cache and therefore it has to go out in order to fetch the contents from memory, that's a long latency operation. In that case, the hardware may switch to one of the other threads and run those. So in other words, it wants to keep this core busy. There's only one execution engine, this core, but it has four threads that it can run on this core. And depending on what these threads are doing, if they are involved in a long latency operation, meaning they're going out, they're not switched out of the processor in terms of operating system scheduling. It is just that these are the threads that have been scheduled to run on this core, and the hardware is switching among these threads by itself, without the intervention of the operating system. It is automatically switching among these threads, depending on what these threads are doing. If this thread does a memory access, which is going outside the processor, then the hardware is going to say, well, you know, this guy is going to be waiting for a while, so let me switch to this guy and let him do its work, because it's possible that what he needs is available in the cache. And if this guy also makes a long latency operation, like a memory access, then the hardware can switch to this guy and to this guy. So if all of these guys are waiting on memory, then of course the core is not going to be able to do anything useful till at least one of these memory accesses are complete. So that's the idea behind hardware multithreading. So it is not very unusual for modern multi-core processors to employ hardware multithreading. So in this example, I'm showing you there are four cores, and in each core, I have four hardware threads. So it is four-way hardware multithreaded core. And I'm showing you two levels of caches, L1 and an L2 cache. L1 cache is specific to this particular core, C1, shared by these threads. Similarly, L1 cache here is specific to this core C2 shared by the threads that are on it. On the other hand, this L2 cache is common for all the cores. So if there's a miss in any one of these L1 caches, the hope is that they may be able to find it in the L2 cache. If the processor has only these two levels of caches, L1 cache and L2 cache, missing an L2 cache is really bad news because then you're going out of the chip. It's a long latency memory operation. And modern multiprocessors may in fact even employ even more levels of caching. In addition to L1 and L2, there may be an L3 cache. It's normal to have modern processors having at least three levels of caches on the chip. An L1 cache associated with the core, and a shared L2 cache, and a shared L3 cache. So that's the structure that you might see in modern multiprocessors. So what we have to think about now is thinking about this cache affinity and the modern multi-core processors and how the operating system should make its scheduling decisions. So here again, there's a partnership between the operating system and the hardware. The hardware is providing these hardware threads inside each core. And what the operating system is doing is picking which threads that it has in its pool of runnable threads and map them onto the threads that are available in the hardware. And clearly, the scheduling decision, what it tries to do is to make sure that most of the threads that are scheduled to a particular core may find their working set in the L1 cache, if possible. And similarly, the threads that are scheduled on this may find its working set in L1 cache of C2, if possible, and so on. And also, the other thing that the operating system may try to do is, if you just take the universe of all the threads that are currently scheduled by the operating system to run on all these four cores, you want to make sure that the working set of all these threads are likely to be found in the L2 cache. Because if you miss in the L2 cache, bad news, right? Because then you're going outside the chip, and that's a very long latency memory operation. And of course, you can extend this idea if there is a third level of cache, but to make things concrete, let's just stick to two levels of caches, L1 cache and L2 cache. And the criterion for operating system is to make sure that the threads that are currently scheduled on the processors that's available, all the cores that are available, what it wants to try and do is make sure that all the threads will find the contents in the L2 cache, because missing in the L2 cache is going to be a long latency memory operation.